Hello, and welcome back to LEGO Star Wars Complete Saga, where in last episode we completed the fourth bonus level of the game, which was A New Hope, and in this episode we are going to be completing the fifth bonus level of the game, which is LEGO City. And for those of you who think that name may ring a bell, well, it should probably remind you of LEGO Indiana Jones The Original Adventures bonus level called Ancient City, because the two are very, very similar. So, without further ado, let's just get straight into this. And I'm going to start off by using, what do I want to use? Oh, we'll use Boba Fett. Why not? LEGO City. In an infinite universe, all things are possible. The epic struggle of the Skywalker family sends turmoil throughout the Force. And in another galaxy far, far away, though, echoes of this drama live on, and a new world awakens. Okay, so. First things first, you may notice the timer at the bottom of the screen. Do not let it freak you out. It only counts up, it does not count down. The timer is merely there to that if you ever play this level again, you can race yourself to see how quickly you can collect a million studs. Which, by the way, the goal of this level is to collect a million studs. So, this should remind you, the name should remind you of Ancient City from LEGO Indiana Jones The Original Adventures, and the aesthetic style of this place should definitely remind you of some of the super bonus levels from LEGO Indiana Jones 2 The Adventure Continues. And I'm going to be showing you everything that there is to see in this area in order to collect a million studs. And some of the basic thing that you might notice right off the bat as you start to destroy some of the stuff is that, unlike in the other levels, studs don't just drop onto the ground for you to pick up. They just go directly into your inventory, which is great because there's no risk of losing studs. Also, you can defeat these guys right over here for some studs, which is cool. Okay, so we're going to start off with the easy stuff. Basically, just you want to shoot as many things as you can as you go. Because obviously the more stuff you shoot, the more studs you're going to get. But I'm also going to be showing you just some of the loose studs that are going to be lying all over the place. And of course you can use the thermal detonator on this right here. We'll get back to the rotator switch in a little bit. Just so you can destroy this for a second. Anyway, so yeah, the loose studs are going to be lying around the place. There's a couple highlighted spots for these. So the first one is going to be right here. Obviously you're going to find that there are some blue studs around this corner right here. If we head back to this corner right here and then we switch to a high jumper, do we have a high jumper? We should have a high jumper. Yep, we have Jar Jar Binks. You can jump on top of this right here and then just grab the blue studs on top of this building. Now all we gotta do is head over backwards to the this little red building over here. I'm gonna actually erase some of these pieces right quick for some flowers, which we can destroy for some extra studs. And then if we switch back here, double jump your way up onto, or high jump your way, I guess I should say, on top of this building. And then up once more for some extra blue studs. No matter how hard you try, you can't high jump on top of that red tower right there. So what we're going to do instead is we're going to ride this thing. Again, I don't remember the name of it. And then use it to fling ourselves up to the top of the tower and grab our hands, or get our hands on the blue stud. Very, very simple. And then the other another spot that we're going to find is going to be towards the bottom left of the area. Because in the bottom left, you may have actually seen this before, is a little mini playground with a bunch of studs for us to get. So there's going to be some on these all of these grapple points right over here. There's going to be one that's hidden inside this, or hidden under this archway, I guess I should say, if I can jump into it. And then there's going to be another one, two more on top of these platforms right here. And then a bunch that are going to be down the slides, which just slide on down, and you can grab them. And now the rest of the loose studs is going to be inside the houses. So as I said, just shoot everything you see as you go about. There's no risk of you not picking up any studs, because as I mentioned previously, they just go directly into your inventory, so there's no risk of that whatsoever. And then another thing that is true is that you cannot lose studs. It is physically impossible for you to lose studs. You cannot lose them. You will always your stud counter can only go up. It cannot go down, which is another very beneficial thing to know, considering we are going after a million studs, which is quite a tall order to fulfill. Yeah, but there isn't much entertainment to be value to be had. I did not mean to destroy Ben Kenobi, but I did. So now we're gonna have to work with that. Just me running around. No, I didn't want to throw a thermal detonator. me running around. Now, I didn't want to throw another thermal detonator. Running around, resealing what I can, and then shooting the rest of the stuff that I can't. Inside this house right here, you'll find a thermal detonator. You can find something that can be thermal detonated, as in addition to some stray blue studs. Resemble this for laser. Now, the blue stud is going to be hidden behind the door. Some more blue studs over here for us to grab. Of course, it is inside a house. You just couldn't see the house previously, so we're going to go inside and then grab the blue studs. There we are. Head out and destroy some of these ones over here. We can also use thermal detonator on that wall back there, but I'm gonna save most of that for a little bit later. For now, I'm just gonna do some basic stud collecting by shooting up. We're doing cleanup work right now. We're going around to destroy everything in the area that's going to give us studs, and then a little bit we'll get into a little bit more of the specifics a little bit later down the line. But for now, just basic destruction, and that's all there is to this. Yeah, in comparison to Ancient City, there's certainly a lot less cool stuff. Like there's no motorcycle racing or anything like that. There's less stuff to do with that, but there is, you know, it is still a level you can just run around, destroy anything you want, so that's nice. Anyway, yeah, so that's I think that's almost everything that we missed the fence over here. We probably missed something else, which I'm going to discover when we're doing cleanup. Ah, there's some trees over here. And then, oh, I completely forgot the fences that are over around these things over here. Yeah, every little bit counts when you're going for a million studs. Just destroy everything that you possibly can, and that will be good to go. And then I must have missed something. Yeah, I missed the trash can, missed the fences. Look at all the stuff that I missed. I missed so much because there is just all these things that can be destroyed. I missed blue studs inside this thing right here. I mean, come on, what am I even doing? I'm missing so. Oh, and I missed a blue stud over here. I thought I went in this house. Look at all the stuff I'm missing. You know, let's destroy this house as well. And I missed another blue stud. The list just keeps going on. The list just keeps going on and on and on. But hey, on the bright side, we are now over halfway to our goal. And we haven't even really done anything aside from collect stray studs and blow the rest of it up. So, take that for what you will. Anyway. Yes, yeah, so are there any seeds we haven't planted? Oh yeah, there's some seeds over here that we haven't planted. Obviously, as I mentioned previously, plant seeds to give yourself some studs, and I really don't want to accidentally throw thermal detonators like I have done previously. Anyway, so, alright, we're going to switch to Ben and Kenobi right here, because another thing we can do is we can force these flower beds down right here. Those are all going to give us some studs. Now what we can do is there's going to be, where are they? Here we go. So what we can do over here is I'm also going to use Ben and Kenobi here, because we have to force these two fancy... force these two fans together right here, which will also cause the street lights to light up. It's pretty neat. And then now that we've done that, we can actually destroy the street lights. You couldn't destroy them previously, you notice. I tried to shoot them, we couldn't do it. But after you reassemble those fans, you can then destroy the street lights, which is obviously going to give you even more studs. So that's nice. And I know that I missed some over here, so I'm just going to keep on moving. Anyway, so what we're going, yep, just keep on moving along, destroy any street lights that get in our path. I think I missed a fence. Yeah, I missed a little bit of a fence over here. Anyway, yeah, so let's keep on moving along, and more streetlights in this area. This is just a bunch of roaming around the area and firing our blaster at anything that is in our sights until we are satisfied with our stud count. Which obviously we will not be satisfied with the stud count until we reach 1 million studs, which is, as I mentioned previously, a fairly tall order to fulfill. But I think we're coming up to the end of all the streetlight. I think that was the... I'm pretty sure that one was the last streetlight that we had to destroy. So I think we're good to go. Anyway. So, alright. Now, the next thing that I'm going to want to show you, I think... I'm going to show you the Lego blocks next, because you'll see over here, there's a series of Lego, there's a series of Lego blocks over here, with four different colors, red, green, yellow, and blue. Yep, you guessed it, we're gonna spell the word Lego. So what you gotta do is, first you wanna force the three red blocks together, then you wanna force three sets of two red blocks together, like so. And yes, there is a specific order that you have to follow in order to spell out the word Lego. So it's basically the set of three on the bottom and top, and then a bunch of twos in the middle. Then for this one, you want to start off with a green three. Then you want to put the two twos, like so. There's going to be a single green that we're going to find back here. We want to put this on next. Then put the other three up. There's the G. Now for the yellow, we're going to start off with a three on the bottom. Then put a one up there. Put a two up. Then a one. And then put the three on top, and that finishes off the E. And now the L is very, very easy. Just put the three on the bottom and put the rest of these singles up on top. And then that will give you your L. And in turn, that will give you the four letters which you need in order to spell out the word Lego. So now that's taken care of, what we can do is we can start to... We're going to start to disassemble these houses by just forcing them down. Because obviously doing that alone will give us some studs. And then also just being able to get into the houses is going to give us the ability to obviously grab these studs right over here. And then once you're done forcing down the stuff, you can reassemble the pieces like so. Into a little miniature house for more studs. Now what we're going to do is we're going to free these people back here. So blow open this thermal detonator and then destroy them like so. And it's a land speeder here. You can't really do much with said land speeder, but I mean, you have a land speeder now, so I guess it'll make traversing the land easier now. Anyway, okay. So over here, we can force these, we can force a lot of stuff. First things first, we'll force you into position down there. We'll force the windows out, just for some extra studs. It's all about the little details in this level to give us as many extra studs as we can. And of course, every house has something that we can interact with. So I'm just going to run around and use the force on all these buildings. This is pretty self-explanatory. I don't really need to say much about it. Just use the force on all the windows and doors. Basically, anything... on the houses that you can use the force on it. Of course, you can reassemble the pieces over here at any time you want. And then jumping in this vehicle is going to reveal some more studs around the area, and of course, the more blue studs that you can pick up, the better. So we're just gonna drive around the road, follow the path, and get all the blue studs that are available to us. You wanna pull them on all the levers in this building right here, and then after you do that, you wanna use the force on this right here to put it onto this thing that we were assembling previously. Let's get this thing out of the way. And then if we jump off, you'll see that we're still not quite done yet, but we're almost assembling this thing. Jump on this thing and then use it to fling yourself up to the top of the tower once again, then reassemble the pieces into an antenna, then simply use the force on this thing in order to force it out of the hole. And here we have a Wookiee flyer. Pretty neat, huh? Yeah, gave us some studs. Can't really do us anything. Can't really do anything special with it, but I mean, it's a Wookiee flyer, so there's that, I suppose. You can also jump in this orange car right here and then pick up all the blue studs that will suddenly appear. Destroy this little house in the back right corner of the area, and then you are going to reveal some pieces which you can then reassemble into a tractor. Just as we've done previously, jump in the tractor and ride it around the map to get more blue studs. You can jump on these things right here, and if you ride them around, they will give us some more studs, or I guess that they will reveal studs which you can collect. And then, of course, another great thing you can do is destroy the entirety of this house right here, and then reassemble the pieces into an AT-ST, which, of course, is great for causing general havoc, and that's pretty much all we needed to do. There's nothing special that we need to use the AT-ST to destroy, but we're almost to a million studs, so at this point, if you've been following along, all you gotta do is just destroy everything in sight, including these little womp rats right here, which I've left unattended to, which, okay, I'm just gonna destroy them by hand because the AT-ST is way too slow. We're almost there. We are just a little ways away from 1 million studs, and then we will be good to go. So we're just gonna use this thing to shoot down anything that has escaped our grasp until this point. Oh, and I almost forgot. This rotator switch right here. Just raise some pieces into a rotator switch that will also give us some more studs. Another hidden secret is that if you walk over this ground in the back left-hand corner of the area, you are going to reveal some hidden flowers. And there are 19 of these things for us to find, so we're almost there. Just a little more ways to go, and then we will be always at all of them. But once you place down all the flowers, that will be you're going to get some studs for doing that. At this point, we just need to destroy a few more things, and that'll give us the remaining studs we need to push us over a million. We're still not there, but don't worry. There's still one more flower bed that we can destroy. Still not enough, that's fine. Let's go ahead and destroy some other stuff. And there is our last million, or our last studs to give us 1 million, and in turn, all studs collected. That is level complete. We got a new best time. And most importantly, we got ourselves a gold brick, meaning we only have one more gold brick left to collect in the entire game. And that will be for this episode. So, Thanks for watching. See you for next time. Hope to catch you all tomorrow for some more LEGO Star Wars Complete Saga. Goodbye.